Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Teacher Fayyaz bin Ahmad here. Good morning to all of you. Hope you're doing fine. Today we are going to start the second part, part 2 of chapter 20, Humans and the Environment, from your biology book, Gareth Williams' New Biology, Nelson Thorne series. Can you please open the page number 323? As we studied in a past session, human and environment interaction explains how man affects the environment and gets affected by it. With the increasing population, more raw materials are being used up. Raw materials fall into two main categories. Renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources can be replaced and non-renewable resources cannot be replaced. So renewable resources, they can be replaced as fast as plants and animals can reproduce and grow. Example is harvesting of timber from forest and fishing. And non-renewable resources, they cannot be replaced once used up. They are gone forever. These include fossil fuels such as coal, oil and natural gas. These are the non-renewable resources. Fossil fuels, oil, coal, natural gas and nuclear. These are the non-renewable energies, energy resources. Alternative energy sources. We do have some alternative energy sources like solar, hydroelectric and wind power. Solar, hydroelectric and wind power are the alternative energy sources. Nuclear power is used in a number of industrialized countries like France, where uranium is used in power stations. Uranium is a nuclear element. Alternative energy sources. Let us see this picture. It explains us the different types of alternative energy sources. Geothermal, wind, hydroelectric, solar, nuclear, and biomass. Another consequence of increasing population is production of more waste. With increasing population, production of waste also increases. So more population leads to more production of waste. If this waste is not handled properly, it may lead to pollution. And also, if this waste is dumped in landfills, then it deprives plants and animals of their natural habitats. So dumping of waste in landfill sites deprives plants and animals of their natural habitats. This is the dumping of waste. This is the waste which is being dumped here. So this deprives plants and animals of their natural habitats. The solution of conserving useful material is to recycle them. We can recycle the useful material. Glass, metals, paper and plastics can all be recycled. Less energy is used to recycle than making a new product. Less energy is used in recycling compared to making a new product from scratch. And major source of waste is packaging. Packaging is the major source of waste. In USA, 35% of municipal waste is from packaging. And in UK, out of the total waste, 75% of the glass, 40% of the paper, and 30% of the plastics, and 50% of aluminium are found. So this is a huge percentage of wastage. Let us see the recycling method here. From the waste, all the material are segregated. Plastics are collected separately, glass is collected separately, paper is collected separately, organic material, metals, and e-waste. Everything is separated and collected to be recycled later on. For example, recycling of paper. From a newspaper, which is now old, which is now a waste, then by recycling this newspaper, so many items can be formed. Telephone directory, egg cartons, building insulation, construction paper, berry boxes, paper board, kitty litter, sheetrock, paper plates. All these things can be made by recycling the paper. Another problem is pollution of the air and land. Exhaust fumes from the cars, they contain lead, carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, and unburnt hydrocarbons. All these are toxic. All these are harmful. And about 60 to 90% of all the air pollution in industrialized countries is from motor exhaust fumes. So motor exhaust fumes cause 60 to 90% of air pollution in industrialized countries. To reduce this pollution from exhaust fumes of motors, catalytic converters could be fitted and new fuels could be used. Ethanol burns more cleanly than petrol, so less air pollution. See this exhaust fumes from a chimney here, from a factory chimney. See how much of air pollution is being produced here. And this exhaust fume from a car, this is also leading to air pollution. Carbon dioxide is given off when fossil fuels like coal and oil are burnt. When coal and oil, like these fossil fuels are burnt, carbon dioxide is released into atmosphere. And also because of the deforestation, because of increased population, deforestation is taking place and more carbon dioxide is accumulating, collecting up or building up in the atmosphere, contributing to the greenhouse effect. This greenhouse effect we'll learn in a later stage, but carbon dioxide is accumulating in the atmosphere because of deforestation and also because of burning the fossil fuels. And this is causing the global warming. Also another gas is sulfur dioxide. This is also released when fossil fuels are burnt. When fossil fuels are burnt, carbon dioxide and sulfur dioxide both are released into atmosphere. This sulfur dioxide together with nitrogen oxides, which are coming out from the exhaust fumes, they form acid rains. Sulfur dioxide together with nitrogen oxides can cause acid rain. And this acid rain, when it falls in lakes and rivers, it makes the water acidic and kills the fish and small invertebrates there. Fish and small invertebrates, they die because of the acidic nature of the rivers and lakes due to acid rains. Let us see how the acidic gases are released into atmosphere, either by the industries or by the exhaust fumes of the motors. The acid gases they are released into atmosphere, like sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxides and carbon dioxide, and with the wind they are carried away to different areas, and these gases they combine with water droplets in atmosphere and they fall down along with in the form of acid rain, and they damage the trees and plants and also the soil. They damage the soil, they damage the buildings, they damage the trees and plants. Acid rain dissolves nutrients like potassium and calcium out of soil, leaving the soil infertile. Acid rain, they dissolve nutrients like potassium and calcium from the soil and they make the soil infertile. And toxic minerals like aluminium, they are washed out into rivers and lakes, killing fish and other wildlife. And acid rain also kills large number of trees like conifers. Large number of trees are killed due to acid rain. The prevailing winds of Europe, they carry the acid gases away over Sweden and southern Norway and cause acid rain there in that area. In Canada, the acid rain is due to the acid gases released by the industries in the United States. So the industries from United States, they release the acid gases, and because of the wind, these acid gases, they are moved over Canada and cause acid rains there in Canada. But there is a technology to combat acid rain. We can use less sulfur in the fuels, like low sulfur fuels can be used. Chemical plants can be installed to remove sulfur from emissions. Flue gas desulfurization removes sulfur from the chimneys of power station. The chimneys of power station, they have a lot of sulfur coming out. This sulfur can be removed by flue gas desulfurization process. Catalytic converters can be fitted in the cars to reduce the nitrogen oxide in the exhaust fumes. So catalytic converter can be fitted in the cars and motors to reduce the nitrogen oxides in the exhaust fumes. This is an example of catalytic converter. The harmful gases like carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, and unburned hydrocarbons, which are in the fuel, these when they are coming out in the exhaust fumes, these are converted to not so harmful but ordinary gases and water, like nitrogen and carbon dioxide and water. So catalytic converter, it reduces the air pollution. Look at this flue gas desulfurization, which is reducing, or it removes the sulfur from the chimneys of power stations. Another thing is chlorofluorocarbons. We call them as CFCs in short. CFCs, they are used in spray cans, refrigerators, air conditioning systems, and making plastic foam. CFC is used in all these fields, along with carbon dioxide, methane, and water vapor, which are the greenhouse gases. CFCs are adding to them, and they cause the global warming. So CFCs are added to the greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, and water vapor, and they cause they change the temperatures and they cause global warming. So CFCs are harmful. CFCs can also cause ozone layer to become thin. They can cause ozone layers to become thin. Ozone layer is a layer in the upper atmosphere of the Earth, which protects the Earth from UV rays. These are the harmful rays causing cancer and birth defects. These are very harmful rays, UV rays. So these are harmful rays, but ozone layer in the upper atmosphere protects the Earth from these harmful UV rays. And what CFCs are doing, these are thinning the ozone layer. They are damaging the ozone layer. And because of this thinning of ozone layer, the first hole in the ozone layer was seen in the Antarctic region in 1985. The first hole in the ozone layer, it appeared over Antarctic region in 1985. The size of this hole is increasing every year. The size of this ozone, the hole in the ozone layer is increasing every year, and a similar hole is developing in the Arctic region also. The first hole in Antarctic region and another one, a similar hole is developing in Arctic region also. This is all because of the CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons. Let us see what they are. See this, air conditioners, refrigerators, aerosol sprays, and also making of plastic foams. All these areas, they use chlorofluorocarbons, and there is a solution to replace these with more environment friendly items. Radiation. Non-natural radiation comes from testing and use of nuclear weapons. Testing and the use of nuclear weapons, and also from leakages from nuclear reactors. In 1986, there was an accident in Chernobyl nuclear power station. In Chernobyl nuclear power station, there was an accident because of which lot of radioactive material, it exploded into the atmosphere, and countries like Poland and Scandinavia were showered with radioactive chemicals. And some types of radiation are known to cause cancers and deformed births. So radiation can cause cancers and deformed births. Agricultural chemicals. Because of the increasing population, more food is in demand. So to increase the world food production, there was a drive between 1945 to 1975, which is called as Green Revolution. So during that drive, more agricultural chemicals were used. The agricultural chemicals are fertilizers and pesticides. So the agricultural chemicals, they doubled the world food production. Fertilizers, they dramatically increase crop yield. But if artificial fertilizers are drained into rivers and streams, then they cause pollution, which ultimately leads to the fish and small invertebrates to die. And pesticides, the other agricultural chemical is pesticide. The pesticides, they kill insects that eat crops, and also they kill weeds which compete with the crops and also fungi that cause diseases. So pesticides, they kill insects, weeds and fungi. Those things are harmful to the crops. About 45% of the crops could be lost if we do not use pesticides. So by using pesticides, we can save the 45% of the crops from being lost. Pesticides saved millions of lives by killing insects that spread malaria, typhus and yellow fever. So many insects, they spread very harmful diseases. These pesticides can kill these insects, which spread the diseases like malaria, typhus and yellow fever. But if these pesticides enter food chains, then it would be a big danger. These pesticides can be dangerous if they get into food chains. So once again, the Green Revolution, it was between 1945 and 1975, where agricultural chemicals were used, which resulted in doubling of world food production. The agricultural chemicals include fertilizers and pesticides. Fertilizers, they dramatically increase crop yield. Artificial fertilizers, if drained into rivers and streams, can cause pollution, thereby killing fish and small invertebrates, etc. Pesticides kill insects that eat crop, weeds and fungi that cause disease. 45% of the crops could be lost if pesticides are not used. Pesticides have saved millions of lives by killing insects that spread serious diseases like malaria, typhus and yellow fever. But pesticides can be dangerous if they get into food chains. We'll learn about this later on, about how they could be dangerous and how they are getting into the food chains. We'll learn about this in our next session. These are the fertilizers. And this is the effect of Green Revolution. More food production has resulted. These fertilizers, they are increasing the crop yield. These are pesticides sprayed in the fields to kill the insects and also to get rid of weeds, and also fungi which cause diseases. So this is end of this topic today. Hope you understood this topic. Thank you. Have a nice day.